today we are going to cover what exactly is the term reflection. Now, to understand the term reflection first, let me create here a new Windows-based application. So I have C sharp, Windows Forms, it can be anything. Let's give reflection demo. Now, there are certain questions which we have to ask ourselves. Like, get the window open. Suppose I select a form, go to properties window. Here we'll find all the properties of the form. Where is the list of properties of the form coming from? Second, select a property. You see some description here. Where is this description coming from? Third, there are certain properties which are bold, and there are most of them which are not bold. Basically, bold implies it is not a default value. Whereas, right click and say reset, it will restore the default value. So, where is it mentioned that this is the default value for a given property? Like that, you drag and drop a button. Select the button, go to properties, events tab, you'll see so many event handlers. I mean, so many events. But when you double click on the button, it generates always click event handler only. So where is it defined that click is the default event for the button? Likewise, select a button, go to properties window, properties, and you'll see always text is selected. So text is the default property. So where are these things defined? Default property, default method, sorry, default event, the if the property is there, where are these things all defined? Yes, these are all defined in the form of attributes for the specified class and its properties. But the point is, now double click on this, when I say this dot, I'm getting the complete list of form properties. So where is this list of form properties defined? All this comes from the metadata of the assembly in which the button class or the form class or the text box class or whatever control we are referring to is presented. That means we now need to basically use an API with which we can read the manifest, we can read the metadata of an assembly. Both the things, we can read the manifest and metadata of an assembly. That's what is the basic requirement now. So how do we get this manifest and metadata? Simple, we have to make use of reflection. So reflection is an API using which one can read the manifest or metadata of an assembly and extract information about a given type. So let us see how exactly we define here. The classes in reflection namespace together with system.type, we are going to see what is system.type, allow you to obtain information about loaded assemblies and the types defined within them, such as classes, interfaces, and value types. You can also use reflection to create type instance at runtime and to invoke and access them. What it means, we'll elaborate with an example. Using reflection API, we can find all the details of any type. That is, we can retrieve information like method, the parameters of the method, the return type of the method, properties, property, data type, everything. Everything about a given class or its member, we can retrieve at runtime the information with the help of reflection API. So it clearly says this information is actually fetched from the type metadata and assembly manifest of an assembly. So assembly manifest and type metadata, we already know, are generated when we build our program. Along with the MSIL code, every assembly also has assembly metadata and assembly manifest. So those are of course in binary form. To read that information, Microsoft has given reflection API. Now, what is this type? See, every type which is loaded at runtime by CLR, all the classes, interfaces, structure, enum, all these things, all these things which are loaded by CLR at runtime are available to us in the form of an instance of type system.type. There is a class called as system.type. So class loader, when loads the class, for every loaded class it creates an instance of type system.type. Like that, for a structure, in any structure loaded, for any enum loaded, interface loaded, delegate loaded, will have an instance of type system.type created. So it is this system.type which we are going to use for reading the information about that particular type. Let us do it with an example. On top, I give now using system.reflection. We want to work with the reflection namespace. And let's also say we have this class test. It has one foo method with two parameters, which are just, let us say, showing in message box for the time being. And then we have one field member and one property, right? A class with one method, one field, one property. So first thing we need to do is get the type instance of that class. How do we get? We have to use an operator called as type of and give the class name. That gets you the type instance of that class. Now once you have the type instance, now starts all your reflection functionality. Here you'll find many methods like find members, get array rank, get constructors, get events, get fields. These are all methods for getting information about the type now, that is test. Let us say to start with, I am interested in all the field members of the type. So for this we have type dot get fields, and return type of this is field info array. Now, can we iterate through this field info array of field info and show, let us say, in message box the name of field. Now run this form, click here, we are getting field 1, and that's the only field which we have in our class. Like that, if I want to get the list of all properties, I have property info array. So type dot get properties. Now I can say for each property info in array of property info, in message box I can say show property info dot name. So all the properties we can get. Property 1 is the property which we have in the test class, only one property. Like that, I can also try here method info, array of method info dot get methods. Now use for each method info in array of method info